Doing community day here. It's 3 days this one because it's the last one for the year. I've caught a lot of shit. Did finally get a shiny Dratini. That was pretty awesome. No shiny Larvitar yet, but I did get shit on by a pidgey. I thought an acorn fell on my head, and then it turns out it was bird shit, which was awesome. I was so sad. It's like, oh damn it. Oh no, and I keep running out of Pokemon space. And I refuse to buy anymore because I was pay to play for a while, pay to win. And now I've gone back to being free to play because I spent way too much money in August. So I was gonna do my Deadpool PG-13 trailer reaction video out here, but I think we're gonna try to head back. I think we're at over 6,000 steps already today. I mean, I need to do a bunch of trades because I am full on Pokemon. I did get a T-Tar earlier today, so that's awesome. So, I will check you guys back when I get home.
Seal!
So, we are on our way back from Community Day from the Capitol. The Capitol's over here, right over there. And there is a street fair going on right now. To let you guys know how good I'm being, there's a Krispy Kreme truck right there. And I want one really bad, but I'm not going to do it because I've done over 6,000 steps today, and as tempting it is to ruin it all with a Krispy Kreme donut, I'm not gonna do it. Or am I? I went to go buy one because I really wanted one, and I was gonna be like, fuck it. But then the dude was like, we're not open yet. So, win for me.
It's open or not open?
It's not open yet. Otherwise, I would have gotten one. Mm. Yeah. Fates. Let me get a photo of this tripod setup I have going on here. Pro, yo. All right, let me get this. Deadpool. OK, Okay, here we go.
Right before Christmas, a good guy in red is coming to theaters with his new sidekick, Fred.
Why am I here?
You're in a PG-13 version of Deadpool.
Filtered.
Sucks for you.
A person of childlike innocence.
I'm a grown man.
And nobody does childlike innocence like you, Fred. Nobody. I need you almost as much as you need me.
I don't need you at all.
He lost his baby face.
To untie you once we're done.
Oh.
I loved your work in Up.
I'm sorry?
Don't get too attached.
Once upon a Deadpool.
Gotta prefer Marvel movies.
We are Marvel.
Yeah, but you're, you know, Marvel licensed by Fox. It's like if the Beatles were produced by Nickelback. It's music, but it sucks.
Whoa!
You were nicer as a kid.
Rated PG-13. Limited engagement in theaters December 12th.
Wait, was that the trailer? That's it?
Are you asking?
Yeah, I'm asking. Is that it?
Yeah, pretty much.
That's it? That's the trailer?
I guess so.
Okay, that sucked. Not that I didn't think that the PG-13 Deadpool wasn't gonna suck, okay? I've been against this the entire time. Because Deadpool has no business being PG-13. Absolutely not. He, as a character, not just from the violence and the sexual innuendos and the totally inappropriate sexual commentary and jokes, but just because from a standpoint he is a very dark and twisted person who has no business being PG-13. I mean, it's sort of like the Punisher. If you're gonna do a PG-13 Punisher, he's no longer the Punisher, he's Jack Ryan, right? So the same thing with Deadpool. Once you do a PG-13 Deadpool, he's just basically Spider-Man. I know a lot of Spider-Man fans are just like totally like rolling their eyes right now, but it's true. It totally is true. Like if you're just counting on the humor to carry it and you're not talking about the superpowers, then yeah, basically the humor is Deadpool Light is Spider-Man. So, and I also believe that once you go PG-13, it's almost impossible to go back to R, because once you've already reached that audience for the PG-13 audience and you've already grabbed that and that's part of your market base, you're not gonna wanna go back. And so once you have a PG-13, if it's successful, then we don't get a rated R Deadpool anymore. And especially if your goal is to market to China, which this movie is to try to get money from China and then also appeal to Marvel, Disney to show, hey, look, I can play with, you know, I belong with Captain Marvel, I belong with Spider-Man, I belong with Iron Man, but you know, it's their pitch to say, hey, don't put us out over with the X-Men, you know, like we belong with the good guys and we can play along and we have the audience for it. And I just think it's a stupid move. I don't know who thought of it. I don't know if this was a Ryan Reynolds thing or if this was the production team that decided this or the Fox team. I think it's more Ryan Reynolds than anybody who really would love to be part of the MCU. I don't blame him, but as a Deadpool fan, I'm not happy with this at all. Are you wearing a Deadpool shirt today? I'm wearing a Spider-Man shirt.
I'm wearing a Deadpool shirt.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah, Deadpool. Represent. What are you wearing? Dragon Ball Z?
Yeah, better.
What you guys think? What you guys think about Deadpool PG-13?
I think it's unnecessary.
Why?
Because he's supposed to be rated R. It's gonna get kids excited for him, and then they're gonna see more of him, and then they'll just basically destroy him as a character.
I mean, you can't really destroy Deadpool as a character, but like...
No, I mean, in terms of like movie format, like he'll just be like watered down for PG-13 movies from then on, because kids will want to see him, and that'll set a precedent. You know, like the death of Superman setting a bad precedent.
Here's my thought. I think that a PG-13 Deadpool in terms of action base could be fine, but they would have to allude to too many things. Because like Venom, I didn't think Venom rated R would PG-13 would work, but it did. And so you can allude to things without showing it. However, the raunchiness that it went to was pretty much the only funny parts of Deadpool 2, in my opinion. So like, they're gonna take out the Basic Instinct parody.
Mm-hmm.
You can't have that in PG-13. And that was the funniest part of Deadpool 2 was the Basic Instinct scene. I mean, so what's left? I mean, just the cheese ball plot stuff.
When is this movie come out?
This Christmas. Yeah.
I think it's a joke.
Oh, you think it's a joke?
Yep.
It's not a joke, yo. It's not a joke. It ain't, and I don't know. I'm just not looking forward to it. But then again, you know, with Deadpool 2 having been kind of disappointing for me, it's not like the end of the world at this point. I feel like I got my Deadpool movie. Deadpool 1 was amazing. It was excellent. It was perfect. And so you can't really ask for anything more than that. Obviously, I wish I could get more of what we got in Deadpool 1.
Although, I do like the ending in Deadpool 2, the after-credits stuff.
Oh, you did?
Where he shoots himself and fixes all the timelines.
Oh, no. No, that was stupid.
It's funny.
See? I mean, they disagree with me all the time, too. we all disagree on everything here. There is not like this... I don't have a popular opinion among my friends either. All right. So, anyways, let me know what you guys thought about the Deadpool 2 PG-13 trailer. First off, I thought it was kind of like weak in terms of like what they're gonna add to it. Doesn't seem like much. And then secondly, what do you guys think about it being PG-13? I think. Wait a minute, I gotta add something in because I just thought of something.
Hold up.
We were just talking off camera for a second and talking about how we fought, you know, Deadpool production team, Ryan Reynolds himself even, fought so hard to get an R rating for the first Deadpool movie and it worked out so perfectly. And now I don't think he cares that it's, you know, that he's going to lose a lot of the original fan base. It's sort of like, I don't know, I feel like he used the original fan base to platform off, and now that Fox is going to Disney, he's like thinking bigger picture, right? He's like, I want to get next level. I don't want to be this niche, cool comic book hero. I want, or superhero, whatever movie. I want to be, you know, top dog, like, production budgets as big as Thor and Iron Man and Ant-Man and you know everyone else, and I want to be part of the Avengers, etc. Or
Avengers.
Yeah, so it's kind of cheeseball. The only thing good I can think of coming out of this is Spidey Pool, but then again, that would be this weird Fox crossover with Disney crossover with Sony, which probably would, man, I don't see that happening, but it has a greater possibility of happening if Spider-Man goes PG-13, because there's no way Sony's gonna let their Spider-Man be with Deadpool otherwise. So that's the only good thing that can come out of this, I think. We'll see. I mean, are we gonna go see it? PG-13 Deadpool? Okay, maybe not.
No.
So I forgot to close out the vlog, so I thought we would say goodnight. We are almost finished editing here and I've reached the end of the vlog and I was like, hey, I just totally cut off and didn't even say goodbye. So, you wanna help me say goodbye, Daisy?
Goodbye, Daisy.
Thank you, you're so helpful. So I'm also open to suggestions from you guys as to what you might want to see. I do have a lot of the days lined up as to the content I'm planning on filling up for Vlogmas, but there are a few days where I am not sure what I'm gonna do, so I totally wanting any input from you guys about what you might want to hear from. I just still do plan to do at least two more reviews before the end of the year, I think. At least one Aquaman, but we'll see how busy it gets. My house is still chaos, despite the fact that I was able to clean up my desk a tiny bit. The house is a complete mess still. I still have Christmas boxes everywhere. Everything needs to go in the attic. It's just crazy.
Crazy!
All right, good night, guys, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.